Hello friends, welcome to the D.El.Ed program of EVS. I am Dr. Romila Soni from Department of Elementary Education, NCERT, New Delhi. Today's our topic is importance and steps of planning for EVS teaching learning. So what unit you are going to focus on? The unit is 27, 7.2 and 7.3. And the focus of today's session is why EVS at the primary stage? Why it is required? Need for planning for teaching learning in EVS. What are the major components of teaching learning process? What are the others? What are the major steps of planning process? What are some essentials for planning process? And what is the role of the teacher in the planning process? Now let's see how we are going to go about for this session. EVS at the primary stage. At the primary stage, environmental education is introduced as environmental studies that we commonly called as EVS as a subject. Environmental studies or EVS has been an integral component of school education in one form or the other for more than four decades. At present, the concept, issues, and problems related to environment are either integrated with different disciplines or introduced as a subject. So you will see that in EVS, we have language, we have mathematics, we have art and craft, and it is integrated in one subject, which we commonly called as EVS. What are the objectives of teaching learning in EVS? Here you need to see that I have mentioned TL. TL is teaching learning. So you need to understand that wherever the TL is coming, it is teaching learning. So what are the objectives of teaching learning in EVS? The NCF 2005, as you all must be knowing, the National Curriculum Framework 2005 indicates the following as some of the objectives of teaching EVS. One, to train children to locate and comprehend relationships between the natural, social, and cultural environment. Two, to develop an understanding based on observation and illustration drawn from live. To create cognitive capacity and resourcefulness to make the child curious about social phenomena, starting with the family and moving on to wider spaces. So things starts going complex, moving from simple to complex. Four, to nurture the curiosity and creativity of the child, particularly in relation to the natural. So we need to keep on nurturing the curiosity of the child. Five, environment that includes artifacts and people. Six, to develop an awareness about environmental issues. Gradually, as you keep reading about environmental studies, you will come to know about so many issues that is related with the environment. 7. To engage the child in exploratory and hands-on activity to acquire basic cognitive and psychomotor skills through observation, classification, and inference. So we need to involve the children with hands-on experiences and activities so that the child will be able to learn faster and grasp better. And all these things are through the process skills. Why there is a need for planning in EVS? If a teacher says that I am an experienced teacher and I can teach my children EVS, no, but still there is a need to plan for an EVS so that you can give your children the best. When you plan appropriately and properly for the activities, for your children, it helps to address the needs of the children. It becomes easy for us to reach the need of each and every child of our classroom. It helps to develop the theme. It helps to develop the concept mapping. So it becomes easy to organize concepts, learning points in logical sequence. So it goes sequence-wise and we know where we are reaching, how we are reaching, and how each of my child in my classroom is learning. How it helps when we plan for EVS. It helps in selecting, in identifying the learning outcomes. So we again, we know that how each child is progressing in my classroom. It facilitates to select and locate learning material and resource availability, which is very important when you read about and when you know about the learning materials and learning resources, you'll come to know that learning in EVS becomes very easy when you have appropriate age level and developmentally appropriate learning material and learning resources. It makes the learning of EVS very easy. Well, when you plan for EVS, it helps teacher in devising learning activities for each and every child. That includes all of the children in your classroom. Now, what are the major components of the teaching learning process? So learners, you need to remember that TL is teaching learning process. The major components of the teaching learning process are, one is the planning process. How you're planning, why you're planning, and what is your content in your planning. Classroom organization. How you're going to organize the classroom when you are actually implementing your EVS activities and actually executing your EVS activities in your classroom with your children. Only then your children are going to enjoy. Third is implementation process. That is a part of your classroom organization and classroom management. So under implementation process, we need to see how we are transacting the activities, which we call learning activities, related to each concept, related to each theme or the chapter. That is very important to maintain, to retain the curiosity of each child. Undertaking assessment for learning. No learning activity is useful if there is no assessment for that particular activity. Their curriculum and assessment, activities and assessment go hand in hand. You cannot say that this is my activity and now I'll do the assessment. Activities and assessment go hand in hand. You need to see how the children is performing, how the child is learning, how I as a teacher is implementing the activity, how I'm helping the child to learn. This helps you to identify the learning gaps in children and also in identifying the teaching methodology gap. If there is any gaps in my teaching methodology, it will help to identify that also. And it will help to provide instant feedback and input so that I can modify. That includes you, and when we say we, as a teacher. So it will provide instant feedback and inputs so that you can modify your concept, you can modify your activities, you can modify your teaching learning transaction methodology and pedagogy. Fourth, recording evidences. This is very, very important, which you are going to know more when you will be learning on assessment. You need to record evidences of how each child is learning, how your teaching methodologies are going when you're implementing the learning activities in your classroom. So recording is very important. It will also help you when you're reporting about the child's progress to the parents and the community. So you must have recording evidences with you in the portfolio of each child. Then another major component of the teaching learning process is conducting summative assessment. If you are very good as a teacher for your formative assessment, if you're continuously observing your child, then definitely there will be no problem in your summative assessment. So summative assessment is another very, very important major component of teaching learning process. It will help you finally to know where your child has reached and what your child has achieved and what you as a teacher has achieved. Reporting progress. Reporting progress, as I said, you are going to report the progress of each and every child to the parents and to the community as well as to your colleagues to further plan your EVS chapters or EVS themes. Finally, reviewing your teaching learning process and replanning for next step. Every time when you review, you will modify your teaching learning process and you plan for your next theme or next concept. Now, what are the major steps in planning process in EVS? So you need to remember it stepwise. So what is step number one? Step number one is identifying the key concepts from theme or the chapter of your EVS book, which you call a theme, can be, you can also call it a concept. Developing concept, theme map. And developing a concept map or a theme map, it will help you to understand how you're going through your term and what are the content you're going to give it to your children related to environmental studies. In other words, it is called a pre-planning tool. Step number two, identifying and selecting learning outcomes from the EVS curriculum. Now, what do we mean by learning outcomes? Learning outcomes is related to your learning objectives. Learning outcomes, when you define, when you identify, when you select the learning outcomes for your EVS curriculum, it will help you to know what you are going to achieve for each and every child of your classroom. So the target is in front of you and it will become easy for you to devise activities and learning experiences for all of the children of your classroom. Step number three. Now, after designing and after selecting the learning outcomes, that mere bacche ko itna aa jana chahiye ya mera bachcha ye kar sakta hai pehle term ke baad, dusre term ke baad ya saal ke ant mein. Uske baad, then you start devising activities. Then you start designing activities for each and every concept and then you start organizing the learning experiences, which includes learning resources, which will include learning material. Step 4. After coming up to step 3, then you have to design and select and identify the learning materials and learning resources. For each of the concept, for each of the theme, you need to identify what should be the learning material and what should be the learning resources for each of my chapter, for each of my process skill, and for each of my concept. When these are in front of you, it will help you and to devise and implement and execute your teaching learning activities in your actual classroom. And you feel so comfortable and so easy because you're half of the things you have already done and you feel confident. Step 5. Till now, you finally need to do classroom organization. And how you're going to do the classroom organization? According to the need of each and every child. When we say the need of each and every child, it includes all children. When we say it includes all children, it includes children with disabilities. So you need to see that if there is any child related to any kind of a disability, then you have to do your classroom organization according to their need. And preferably small group, organized small group activities, small group seating is the best seating in the active classroom. What are the essentials for planning process? Selection of age-appropriate concepts, learning materials, and transactional strategies. When we say that selection of age-appropriate concepts, and do not forget that concepts are themes. Concepts turn into a project and concepts turn into a theme. So never get confused between that concepts are something different and themes are something different. It is one of the same thing. And selection of age-appropriate learning materials. It is not that the child is of around 8-year-old and your material is of very high level. And otherwise also, if your child is 10-year-old and your material is around 3-year-old. So you need to see that your learning materials need to be age appropriate. If the learning material is not age appropriate, it may make the child frustrated, and if the material is not challenging, then it will fail to satisfy the curiosity of the child. So you need to manage both the things. Transactional strategies. How you are going to actually implement or transact your teaching learning activities and your strategies, your methodologies with your children. So you have to be very careful and you have to do the pre-planning. Spiral approach of planning. This is very trendy and it will help you to know the continuous growth and progress of the child. Spiral approach of planning is progressive planning. Like you need to plan it, you need to see how much my child has learned in the previous concept and now how you are going to be more advanced in your next theme. So you need to connect each and every theme and the concept with the previous theme and with the next theme so that there are connections in your themes and connections in your concepts. What are the other essentials for holistic planning and planning process? Following a holistic approach. You need to see that it need to be integrated approach. Child-centered approach. You need to see the need level of the child, age of the child, interest of the child. If the child is not interested, the child will never be interested in your learning. Feasibility aspect, time management. So you need to see all these essentials for a good implementation of EVS activities in the classroom. What should be the role of the teacher when you are in the teaching learning process of EVS and when you are planning, active planning for your EVS classroom? You need to be a good reflective teacher. Always review and reflect on the teaching learning process, keeping in view the attainment of LO. Remember, LOR, learning outcomes. Accepting own gap areas. Accepting own gap areas means teachers need to reflect on where I was going wrong, where I was wrong, how I'm going to modify my teaching learning strategies, how I'm going to improve my teaching learning strategies. It is not that every time the child is not able to do. It's maybe the child is not able to do because there is some gap in my teaching learning activities. So when you look at and when you reflect on your own gap areas, it will become easy for you to improve your teaching learning practices and pedagogy. Now you need to remember certain other things as well. Always you need to plan that how you're going to recapitulate. Recapitulate is going back. What are the highlights of my concepts? Which activity children enjoyed most? Which activity children enjoyed least? Where I have to do improvement? Where I was lagging behind? What are the key messages of this concept? What are the key messages of this theme? What vocabulary my children learned during this concept? And how I am going to enrich the vocabulary in the next concept? And what I want my children to exhibit? So you have to keep all these points in your mind. Some more points. Now this is the time to present your lesson plan. So teachers, are you ready to present your lesson plan? No. You need to reflect on your plan again. It will help you to improve your plan better so that you'll feel confident before you enter in your EVS classroom. Check again how you can modify it, what worked well, and so on. Discuss with your colleagues. Engaging children in a study. Study is again a project. This is a new term, so you should also know, like study, which you commonly term as project, here it is written as study. Identify appropriate topics for children to study over a period of time. Topics again are concepts. Involve children in investigating a topic and finding answers to their questions. Make a web with the children. It's not that generally teachers make a web. Web also means a concept mapping. Generally, teachers make a webbing or a concept mapping on their own or with their colleagues. Involve children in making a web. Children understand the concept better. Identify a good topic or a concept according to the need and the age level of the children. Topic must match the developmental abilities of the children. So you should know what a concept mapping is used for. A concept mapping is a technique used to organize information or thoughts. So encourage your children to do the brainstorming when you do the webbing, and you'll get wonderful ideas from the children. See, this is a sample of a concept mapping of a study of grocery store, which you commonly call, agar aap rashan ki dukaan mein jayenge, to aap kya kya dekhenge? And how you're going to do the brainstorming? To bachcho se aap poochhiye ki when you'll go or visit a grocery store, what you observe there? And this, what I am showing you, is a very limited thing. But when you ask children, you will be amazed the children come with the wonderful answers. So brainstorming helps. So grocery store is a project or a study. So ask people and their jobs, different kinds of food. How food is kept fresh in the grocery store? What are the machines used at the grocery store? How customers buy food? How food gets to the store? Where food comes from? And these are the focus area where you'll ask the children and children will give you wonderful replies. This is again exploration as well as problem solving. When you ask the children, okay children, when you go and visit the grocery store, what are the people and their jobs you find? To bacche aapko jawab denge. Kaun kaun se tarah ke aadmi, kis kis tarah ke kaam karte hain? Where the food comes from? Grocery store mein khana kahan se aata hai? How food gets to the store? Store pe food kaise pahunchta hai? Kis tarah ki machines store mein lagi hoti hain? So it will help the children to brainstorm. And this is a critical thinking skill and children's brain becomes active. Now see, this is a little more elaborate. From where did the food come from? Why don't the fruits and vegetables get rotten in the grocery store? Grocery store mein phal aur sabjiyan kyun nahi sadte? Jabki hum ghar mein laate hain, to kuch dinon ke baad wo sad jaate hain. So these are the problem solving. And this is again, the children are doing the exploration, thinking. Who puts the food on the shelves? What are the striped lines on the boxes, which you commonly call barcodes? Why does the door open when you walk in front of it? Darwaza apne aap kyun khul jata hai jab aap darwaze ke paas jaate ho? How much does food cost? So try to find out what your children know about the topic and keep their interest alive. And start teaching from where the children's interest lies. Jahan bachcho ki ruchi hai, padhana wahin se shuru kariye. And phir dekhiye bachche kitni jaldi seekhte hain. Create a class grocery store. Now this is another very interesting extension project after visiting a grocery store outside. Bring a balance or scale, jisko aap tarazu bolte hain. Bring a balance scale to see how it works. Let the children, usne sabji ki dukaan mein bahut baar dekha hoga. Lekin jab aap classroom mein rakhte hain, to bachche ki curiosity dekhne laik hoti hai. Grow real vegetables for the class store. Bachcho se seeds mangaiye, classroom mein unko sow karne ke liye boliye. And ask the children to observe how vegetables grow. Kaise patte phootte hain, kaise sprouts aata hai. Find out where the food comes from. Sort healthy foods from the junk food. So classification skill is there. Find out what happens if foods are not kept or in the refrigerator. So creating a class grocery museum is another a creative and innovative idea for EVS. More ideas for a store. Draw a map of a grocery store. Taste various ethnic foods. So there is so much of a fun. It is not boring. Learn about different jobs in the store. Find out the rules in the grocery store. Find out how people with little money buy food. Jinke paas bahut kam paise hote hain, wo store se kis tarah se saman khareedna manage karte hain. So, brain is still active. To summarize, what teaching learning methods would be effective? Linking lessons, concepts with the previous one. Never forget that you have to make connections. supporting the learning cycle for each child of your classroom. Each child is important. Never forget that each child's learning pace and learning style is different. During the topic, there are more things to summarize what we have already talked about, posing questions. Do not forget to ask why to the children and also answer why of the child. Visit a relevant site. If you're talking about plants, visit the outside, take the children outside for a nature walk, let the children observe types of plants, visit to a plant nursery. Have discussions, explore material, create experiments, and listen to the children and ask questions. So, recalling, identify the learning objectives, and remember how you're going to introduce the concept and the topic. And remember, the teaching learning methods would need to be effective. Linking lessons, supporting the learning cycle of each child is important. And we are at the time for concluding this session, and we need to remember that why good planning is very important. We need to remember when we pre-plan, good planning is possible, and good planning means thinking ahead. So learners, be creative while planning and keep doing a good concept mapping. Thank you so much.